Gebran Bassil is at the center of Lebanon's latest political crisis. He is the foreign minister and also the son-in-law of the president, the head of a Christian political party, and along with his ally Hezbollah, he controls parliament and cabinet. And some accuse him of using those powers to undermine the country's sectarian-based power-sharing system.
All of Bassil's approach in politics is an assault on the status quo, which was founded by the Taif Accord. So Bassil is trying to find the new place for a strong Christian leader.
Christians once dominated Lebanon's politics. The civil war changed that. The Taif Accord of 1989 removed powers from the Christian president and gave them to the Sunni Muslim prime minister. Bassil's Free Patriotic Movement party say they are claiming back what is rightfully theirs.
We have what we have in terms of parliamentary representation, ministerial representation, confessional representation. So it's just that we're taking our part in the system. Before, Christians were marginalized, so this their part that was going to others.
Prime Minister Saad al-Hariri is in a weak position. He lost parliamentary seats in last year's elections, partly due to a new electoral law that critics say favor his rivals. And his traditional ally, Saudi Arabia, has lost influence here.
Saudi Arabia played a key role in brokering the Taif Agreement, which was named after the Saudi city where it was signed. A lot has changed since. Relations between Lebanon and Saudi Arabia have been strained by the growing political influence of the Iranian-backed Hezbollah and its allies in Lebanon.
Hezbollah was not a political actor when Taif was signed, and its ally, Bassil's father-in-law, President Michel Aoun, refused to recognize the deal and was forced into exile.
There's a huge crisis. It's not easy to make changes to the Taif Accord. It was the outcome of 15 years of war, and any amendment could start another war, which no one wants.
But there is already a new reality, and it won't be easy to shift the new balance of power in Lebanon. Zeina, Khodr, Al Jazeera, Beirut.